The present video, current electricity part 4, we will be discussing heat produced by electric energy, expression for electric energy and expression for electric power. Let's see what heats a current carrying conductor. When current is passed through a conductor, the free electrons in it begin to drift against the direction of the electric field. This we have studied when we talked about the concept or mechanism of the current transfer in a conductor. The electrons, they get accelerated under the action of the field, because you have free electrons, you apply the field applies force. Force provides acceleration, and acceleration provides increased velocity, which we call drift velocity, and hence the electrons gain kinetic energy in addition to the already possessed thermal energy of the electrons. So whenever we pass current through a conductor, the free electrons in the conductor acquire additional kinetic energy. The energy gained by electrons is given by E into V, where E is electron charge, because we know the energy is given by Q into the potential difference. Charge on electron is E and V is the potential difference. So each electron acquires this energy, EV. This energy is lost in subsequent collision against the atoms or ions in the conductor. The ions therefore begin to vibrate faster, which causes the rise in temperature or heating of the conductor. Now let's see how much heat energy will be produced. For the purpose, we take a resistance R and apply a potential difference V across its ends. Suppose potential difference V is applied across the ends of a conductor of resistance R. Let I denote the current passing through this conductor. I is the current. By definition of electric current, we know I is Q by T. So charge transferred in T seconds will be Q equal to I into T. Now, by definition of potential difference, we have potential difference V equal to work upon charge. So work done will be V into Q. Q we have already calculated, IT. So work done is heat energy produced equal to charge multiplied by potential difference, or heat H equal to the work done on the free electrons equal to Q into V, or substituting for Q we get VIT. Using Ohm's law here, V can be written as I into R. So you get I square RT, or you can substitute for I as V over R. So that gives you another relation, V square T by R. So heat produced can be calculated by QV or VIT or I square RT or V square by R into T. These relations will lead us to the expressions for the electric power. Power is rate of consumption of electric energy, means electric energy consumed divided by time, which is VI, because VI is VIT upon T, or I square RT upon T, that gives you I square R, or V square T by R divided by T, or V square by R. So there are three expressions for power: VI, I square R, or V square over R. In SI units, if you express V in volts, R in ohms, I in ampere, then the power will be in watt. Now there is one important question which you can think about. We have P equal to VI equal to I square R equal to V square over R. Now let's see how does power vary with R. If you use this relation, you will find, you will assume, it appears that P is proportional to R. More resistance, more power. If you look at this relation, it appears that larger resistance, smaller power. So how does power vary with R? Does it increase as R increases, or does it decrease as R increases? The solution lies in the fact that when you take this relation, P is equal to V square over R, P will be inversely proportional to R if V is constant. So if for a constant potential difference, the power is inversely proportional to R. For constant current, power will be directly proportional to R. You may subscribe to our channel CBSE042 and like the video. For feedback, you can write to ikg54@yahoo.co.in and visit this blog physicsbeacons.wordpress.com for more topics and videos in physics. Wish you happy learning, and thanks for watching the video.